little rocker belongs to the daughter of a friend of mine. One of the rockers broke, and he asked me if I could replace it, and I said, sure. So I'm making this video because the first time I tried this, I drilled the holes at the wrong angle. They fit, but they were backwards, so that didn't help out. Since I pretty much had to figure this out on my own, I couldn't find any videos on how to replace rockers on a rocking chair. I figured, what the heck, I'd just make a video of it. So this is how I went about it. Instead of trying to make another rocker exactly like this one, I'm just going to replace this one as well. That way I know that the two rockers that I make are exactly the same. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to trace this onto the new piece. Now you may wonder why I traced it so many times. The edge has got a gentle curve to it, so I want to make sure that the pencil lead actually got down into the curve itself. As you can see, like this line right here, if I'd have cut on that, it would have been off. So trace it several different times to make sure that you're getting an accurate trace. I'm just going to flip this over and do the same thing, avoiding the cracks that I can see. So those are two pieces. So we're going to take this over to the bandsaw and cut out both of these. Before we head to the bandsaw, I want to run this through the joiner. I want the bottom to be as flat as possible, because when I cut it out, I'm going to save this bottom chunk as a cradle for when we start drilling holes on the drill press. So run this through the joiner real quick. There we go. Now we'll take it over to the bandsaw. So there's the cradle that I'm going to use whenever I go to the drill press. Now we'll take these two and we'll join them together with some double-sided tape, take it over to the bandsaw, and make sure they're both exactly the same. Now that all the sanding's done and both of these are identical, it's time to locate and drill the holes. So in order to do this, you're going to need a few things. First, you're going to need one of the original rockers, preferably one that's not already broken, a couple of pieces of dowel that are the same size as the holes that you're going to be drilling, in my case 3/4, bevel gauge, square, pencil, a mallet. Obviously you need your two new legs, your two new rockers. And this is the piece I was telling you about earlier. This is the one where I said we want to try and keep the bottom of it as whole as possible. And you'll see why when we go over to the drill press. For now, what we're going to do is line up these rockers. Now, the biggest thing that you have to consider is not necessarily the relationship of this hole to the front or this hole to the back. It's the distance between this hole and this one. So what I'm gonna do is, now that I have this in place, I'm just gonna clamp it so that it doesn't move on me. I'm gonna take the square. We're just gonna transfer these lines straight over to the new one. For the beginning of the hole and for the end. Same thing with the back one. And now that we have it on one, we can transfer it on over to the other. Now we know where to drill the holes on the new rockers, but we don't know what angle. That's why we need these pieces of dowel. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this, take a dowel, and put it in both the front and the back. And presumably both of these will be at the same angle, but that's not always the case. Okay, the reason that we saved this cutoff was to hold the new rockers as we drill, but also to help set up the drill press for the proper angle. So we'll put this in here like this, and we'll take it over to the drill press, and we'll go from there. So what I've done is I've taken the rocker with the dowels in it, put it inside the cutoff, and used that to set the angle of my table. So now, even though I know that's not the right size bit, I know that we're at the right angle. Now, before we start drilling, we need to know how deep we need to drill. So I'm gonna show you what I did. Now, there may be 100 different ways to come up with this, but this is what I did. So I took the original rocker, and I found a piece of scrap that would fit down in the hole. And I pushed it all the way down to the bottom. Now I know I want to drill to this depth from the point at which it makes contact with the workpiece right there. So I just marked a line across there, marked it as back, and then did the same thing for the front. Now the front wound up being a little bit more shallow. So now that I have the measurements, I remember we want to drill from this line all the way down to this line. So we're going to advance the bit until it makes contact with the workpiece. Lock it. We're going to use the line that we drew to set the depth stop. Perfect. We'll do this same thing with the other one. Putting it in, sliding it all the way back to the back. Perfect. Now we're going to set up for the front. Now, same as before, in advance until the bit makes contact with the piece and lock it. Now, again, the drill bit is making contact with the workpiece at the back end. So we're going to use the back line to set the depth stop. Check it. Perfect. Perfect. And now I'm all set up to drill the through holes. head to the bandsaw, I want to make sure to run this through the joiner to make one plate. Whenever I go to drill the holes in the, whatever that thing is over there, drill press. Okay. Run this through the joiner real quick. Helps if the joiner has power. Perfectly 90 degrees to the other one. F*** off, man. The other one. If you don't... That wasn't supposed to happen at all. Well, now I've got to stop this and glue this back together again. The reason we saved this cutoff earlier, was not only to make sure that the rock... We saved this cutoff for two reasons. Helicopter overhead. Nice. Let's wait for that to pass. I don't know why that makes me so happy.